start off today by citing a quote for all of you. According to an article published by Texas A&M University, 10% of the world's coral reefs have already been destroyed. Now, I know that sounds like a small figure, only 10%, but you have to realize that the coral reefs is one of the most biologically diverse areas of the world. That is hundreds of thousands of species, many that hadn't even been discovered yet, that have been destroyed and eradicated. This quote was the basis for my overall topic of today. Now, coral reefs are being eaten alive by sea urchins, which is being caused by the overfishing of certain reef fish. These are the natural predators of these urchins. I would first off like to explain the impact on the overall reef, second, the types of fish involved, and third and finally, introduce to you guys a way to fix and alleviate this problem. My credibility, of course, on this matter is being that I take this regard, this subject, very personal, being that I do have my own reef tank and I have experienced sea urchin reef destruction firsthand, and it's kind of important to me. So first, I'd like to start off with the impact on the reef. This is an image of a reef before and after, showing after the sea urchins have come through. And according to a quote from an 18-year study of research performed by Kenya's coral reefs and the Wildlife Conservation Society, as well as in collaboration with the University of California at Santa Cruz, they have found that overreefed systems have a 75% more likely chance of excess sea urchin growth and subsequent reef destruction. Now, these sea urchins may seem small, but they can definitely eat more than they weigh. They are capable of wiping out whole entire ecosystems, as I said, turning this into this. Destruction is basically all they leave. But I will say that they can be beneficial to a point. As long as there's not too many of them, they're helpful to the reef. They can help clean it of unwanted algae that actually can destroy the reef faster than the sea urchins. It's just when overfishing removes their predators that things happen and we get too many of them. Now, for my next subject, I'd like to introduce the impact of the fish that are actually involved. Now, the fish that are being overfished are primarily the wrasse and triggerfish species. Now, this species of fish indicated right here is this is actually a wrasse as well as these. These fish are the only few types of fish in the natural ocean that can actually eat a sea urchin due to their advanced safety mechanism of their spines. Now, many of them happen to be poisonous, and these are the only fish that have developed a technique to actually get in, attack, and consume these fish. Consume these sea urchins. However, these fish are also one of the most popular fishes used in the aquarium trade, as well as they are a delicacy in certain restaurants. Now, but those aren't the only fish that get impacted by this problem. If this was to continue, according to greenplanet.org, if we don't stop this overfishing and let the reefs keep dying at the rate that they are due to these sea urchins, not only will the reefs die, but we'll also see loss of butterfly fish, lobsters, dolphins, sharks, and sea turtles. I don't know about you, I don't really care about the sharks as much, but I like my dolphins, and I like my turtles. And so I feel like we should do our best to help and protect those animals and save the reef. I mean, this is one of our planet's greatest features. We are called the Blue Planet. We might as well keep it that way and keep our oceans happy. So now, the main sea urchin that is the problem is the D. antelari, or D standing for diadema, as its common sea urchin name is. It is a black, long-spined sea urchin, and according to the Encyclopedia of Life, a mature individual of D. antelarium can actually reach up to 500 millimeters in diameter and are capable of wiping out an entire coral reef colony just by itself. Imagine, though, a whole swarm of those that have been reproducing at an excessive rate due to the lack of predation and are now attempting and consuming vast amount of land and reefs. Mm-hmm. Now, for my final subject, I would like to introduce to you how we can fix this problem. This is a fish hatchery system. These are already in place, but they are mainly used for commercial fish, such as salmon, koi, and many of the food trays in the larger fish species. But this one system can actually be used by taking two fish individuals, and with just food, water, and a little bit of money, you can have a massive population of fish growth within the span of a year. This one system alone could produce enough of one species of fish to repopulate an entire reef, thus cutting back on the sea urchin's consumption. The system is a little bit costly, however. These do run about $50,000, but for your $50,000 investment, you do get a lot. You get basically unlimited fish. These last for many, many years, and the only thing they require maintenance-wise is a regular cleaning, water change, and maintenance on the pumps and features. So the way it works, though, is that this is the pool which the fish live in. It's all controlled through pumps and circulatory motions that circulate new water and fresh water as well as sterilize it, thus making the fish happy, being that they cannot catch diseases, being the water is actually sterile. They are fed, and then at the appropriate time when they have reached the right age and size, they would then be released back into the wild. We would be able to set up facilities in large numbers where we could have a few of these of each type, where we'd grow each different species, and then release them into the wild to help combat this growing problem. Now, I would like to also persuade you all to get in contact with your local aquariums and learn about this problem firsthand. They've used this technique for years to grow their own livestock for the shows. And it's something that we can easily use to alleviate a major problem in today's reef system. And finally, I would like to leave you guys all with a statistic to think about. According to Life and Death of Coral Reefs by Charles Berkland, at the current rate of coral reef degradation, it is estimated that over 68% of the world's reefs could be lost within the next 30 years. But there is good news. If we address this now and deal with this the way it is and stop overfishing and incorporate using these systems to grow and reproduce these fish and boost the population, we can save it and we can make a difference. This can save our reefs, and this can save not only the reefs themselves, but also commerce. Reefs are huge, huge values to countries that happen to have them. Look at the Great Barrier Reef and say one of the world's greatest attractions. Many people visit every day. And it's something that we should make sure to save and work on keeping it the way it is. We can fix this. Thank you.